trying to break down this game, there honestly isn't too much to it. It's a simple 3D adventure where you talk to some people, collect and trade a few things, and then turn in the items to complete it. If you're the kind of person who comes in for the action and gameplay mechanics, then this game probably isn't gonna be for you. I know this doesn't sound too good now, but if you're open and willing to let yourself get lost in its quirky nature and charming dialogue, then this is gonna be an hour that you're not gonna regret. Plus, at the time of this review, the second game is already out, and there's a third in development. This game, unfortunately for me, sat in my playlist for a few too many years. I wish I'd picked it up sooner. Cause you know, indie games like this, they're just able to do something that I don't believe AAA titles will ever be able to achieve. And it's not that AAA developers are at fault, and it's also not a bad thing either. This is just because the minds behind indie games have this space where they can be as creative as they want. They don't have the push from owners, CEOs, there's no corporate culture messing around with them, and that gives this sense of freedom that we don't really get to see elsewhere. You almost won't find this anywhere else. The Haunted Island, a frog detective game, I think it's fun. It's really quirky, and the dialogue is super playful. This is the kind of game I truly believe you will know immediately if you're gonna like it or not. But at the same time, if you're still not sure if you're gonna like it, I say go for it. It's something unusual that I think should be enjoyed. And hey, if you're still not convinced, you can check out part of the playthrough I did for it on my other channel, or maybe even come check it out live.